Is this poison ivy? And what's the best way to get rid of it? And this is Miss Dorothy. So what do we think about that?
I use Roundup.
I was going to say, the glyphosate works.
Okay.
There's several things that will do the trick. You can use, some things seem to work better during certain times of the year. This time of the year when the poison ivy is starting to bloom and Roundup does when it's actively growing,
right.
Roundup does a pretty good job. I've had a little success mixing a little 2,4-D in with the Roundup because 2,4-D is a growth regulator, and it actually causes plants to grow themselves to death, the ones that it kills, but it might accelerate the growth of the poison ivy a little bit so that it can be more rapidly absorb the glyphosate. But most of the time I just use straight Roundup, and it may take more than one application.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
What I will do if it's like that on the pitcher, I'll just spot spray it, realizing that whatever I hit around it's probably going to be damaged a little bit, but I'll sacrifice it to kill poison ivy. If it's going up a tree or something like that, I'll cut the stem, and it's pretty easy to recognize poison ivy vines. It's got all those hair-like structures on it. I'll cut the vine, cut an inch of it out so it doesn't graft itself back together.
Sure.
And then when it puts new growth out below where I cut it, then I'll spray it. And it usually will be really rapidly growing then because it has such a massive root system.
Right.
And I'll let it get a little bit of growth there before I go back and spray it again. But you just stay with it and with glyphosate, and that's probably the safest thing that you can use around your house.
But then again, there's probably somebody who does not want to use glyphosate product. Mm-hmm. So what do we do then? Long sleeve shirts, pants, whatever, gloves.
Rubber gloves. Keep in mind the urushiol is what causes the problems, and it is an oil. You can't see it. It can get on mm-hmm. your gloves and your mm-hmm. pruning shears and your clothes, and it's like oil that you get out of your lawnmower or something like that. It stays, it doesn't evaporate and go away. Get it on your clothes, a jacket or something like that, and put it on 6 months later.
And
you know,
still
grab
there.
It and it can still affect mm-hmm. you. So if you're gonna deal with it, I Tyvek up. I know I'm gonna be, and I'm very allergic to it. Most people that are say they're not, they just haven't got it yet. When it hits you, it hits you hard.
Right.
But you can use Tyvek and rubber gloves and throw that away. Right. You don't have to worry about washing it. You can buy those, homes or garden centers, a lot of safety, pesticide safety gear. But you can use that kind of stuff and throw it away when you're out there actively messing with it. But I mean, if you don't want to use herbicides, you can pull it up all you want to and mow it down all you want to. It's going to keep coming back.
Right.
There's no way you can eradicate it without using a herbicide.
Unless it's small enough that you can get the whole root system.
Pull it up by the root.
Yeah, if it's small enough, but it has to be really small.
Yeah. And the seeds are spread by birds,
right?
And
right.
you may have some seedlings out there, but most of the ones that I have in my landscape that come up, they're not coming up from a seed. There's a larger root system underneath there, and I may pull it up, and still, it's going to come back.
Thanks for watching. If you liked it, subscribe. We have hundreds of family plot videos for you to view.